توفي بالمدينة المنورة أبوه عبد الله وكان قد اجتاز بأخواله بني عدي من الطائفة النجارية ومكث فيهم شهرا سقيما يعانون سقمه وشقواه ولما تم من حمله على الراجح 9 أشهر قمرية وآن للزمان أن ينجلي عنه صداه حضر أمه ليلة مولده الشريف آسية ومريم في نسوة من الحظيرة القدسية وأخذها المخاض فولدته صلى الله عليه وسلم نورا يتلألأ سناه ومحياك الشمس منك مضيء أسفرت عنه ليلة غراء ليلة المولد الذي كان للدين سرور بيومه وازدهاء مولد كان منه في طالئ الكفر وبال عليهم ووباء يوم نالت بوجهه ابنة وهبي من فخار ما لم تنله النساء وأتت قومها بأفضل مما حملت قبل مريم الأزراء وتوالت بشرى الهواتف أن قد ولد المصطفى وحق الهناء هذا وقد استحسن القيام عند ذكر مولده الشريف أئمة ذو رواية وروية فطوبى لمن كان تعظيمه صلى الله عليه وسلم غاية مرامه ومرماه أطل اللهم قبره الكريم بعرف شذي من صلاة وتسليم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه.
The chapter that was recited was in the cutting of Sayyidina Amr radiallahu ta'ala anha, of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and it took us towards the birth of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Imam Barzanji rahimahullahu ta'ala states here that at exactly 2 months of cutting the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the father and the noble father of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, as authenticated by Imam Suyuti rahimahullah, that the parents of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were Muslim and part of the ummah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and believers in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala an, after 2 months as Sayyidina Amina radiallahu ta'ala an had cutting the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed. And he had gone to visit his relatives in Medina. At the time it was known as Yathrib, and today it is known as Medina. And as a side note, you should know that we do not call it Yathrib anymore. According to the Hanafi scholars and according to the Hanafi fuqaha, to call Medina Yathrib in this day and age is makruh tahrimi. Rather, some ulama stated clearly that it is sinful and a person will have to make tawbah towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for naming Medina Yathrib in this day and age. So he had traveled towards there, and this is where he had passed. Sayyidina Abdullah, the father of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And he had stayed with them for about a month while he was ill, and they looked after him, and this is when he had passed. وَلَمَّا تَمَّ مِنْ حَمْلِهِ عَلَى الرَّاجِحِ 9 أشهر قَمَرِيَّةٍ. After 9 lunar months, the time for the birth of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam came. آن للزمان أن ينجلي عنه صدا حضر أمه ليلة مولده. And when Sayyidina Amina radiallahu ta'ala anha was giving birth to the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala sallam, the miracles will come later on, we'll inshallah ta'ala mention them in the next following chapters. But at this point Imam Barzanji mentions that when she, Sayyidina Amina radiallahu ta'ala anha, started giving birth to the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala sallam, Sayyida Asiya, Sayyida Asiya radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of Fir'aun, okay, and Sayyida Maryam, the mother of Sayyidina Isa ala Nabiyina wa alayhi salatu wa salam, both presented themselves in a group of heavenly women to come and witness the birth of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rather deliver the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into this dunya. And you should take a note that according to us, these two women, Sayyida Asiya and Sayyida Maryam, will be the wives of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hereafter, according to the narrations that have been narrated by the Muhaddithin. So what happened was that when Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came into this dunya, Imam Barzanji rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu narrates a piece of poetry. He stays here, his face shining like the sun. A clear moonlit night unveiled him, a night of a birth that along with its day was a joy and a blossoming for religion. A birth that brought grief and a plague to the disbelief that was rising. That he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even before he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, idols were falling. That was a sign for what is to come. A day that the daughter of Wahab, Sayyida Amina was the daughter of Wahab. A day that the daughter of Wahab became a proud mother, the like of which no woman had ever attained. No woman has attained a child like Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So just like there is no one like Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no one like Sayyida Amina, the mother of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She brought forth to her people he who was more excellent than the one carried by the Virgin Mary in a previous era. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidul Anbiya, and Imamul Anbiya, and Imamul Mursaleen, and Sayyidul Mursaleen. So he is greater than Sayyidina Isa ala Nabina wa alayhi salatu wa salam. He has a rank, a great rank, but the rank of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is greater than Sayyidina Isa ala Nabina wa alayhi salatu wa salam. Exclamations of the joyous news came in quick succession. The chosen one has indeed been born and happiness has established itself. Meaning this call was made. This call was made to the whole of the universe. As in later on you see, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken away and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken around to the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that everybody recognizes him sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So this is وَتَوَارَتْ بُشْرَ وَاتِفِ أَنْ قَدْ وُلِدَ الْمُصْطَفَى. This call has been made, the chosen one has indeed been born and happiness has established itself. At this point, whenever these words are recited, even in Hadra, wherever you are, وَتَوَارَتْ بُشْرَ الْهَوَاتِفِ أَنْ قَدْ وُلِدَ الْمُصْطَفَى وَحَقَّ الْحَنَاءُ. We stand in honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam birth. Why? Because his birth is the cause and the reason for everything which we have today. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not allow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be born, then we wouldn't have every honor that we have today. وبرز صلى الله عليه وسلم وادعا يديه على الأرض رافعا رأسه إلى السماء العلية موميا بذلك الرفع إلى سؤدده وعلاه ومشيرا إلى رفعة قدره على سائر البرية وأنه الحبيب الذي حسنت طباؤه وسجاياه ودعت أمه عبد المطلب وهو يطوف بها تلك البنية فأقبل مسرعا ونظر إليه وبلغ من السرور مناه وأدخله الكعبة الغراء وقام يدعو بخلوص النية ويشكر الله تعالى على ما من به عليه وأعطاه وولد صلى الله عليه وسلم نظيفا مختونا مقطوع السر بيد القدرة الإلهية طيبا ضهينا مقهولة بكحل الإناية عيناه وكيل ختنه جده بعد 7 ليال سوية وأولم وأطعم وسماه محمدا وأكرم مثواه أطل اللهم قبره الكريم بعرف شذي من صلاة وتسليم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. In this chapter, Imam Barzanji rahimahullah ta'ala mentions that when he sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam was born, as you all know from when we had the Mawlid gatherings, that the more we open this book up, the more we can do it. We can spend a whole year, a year speaking on this book, and we'd only probably get through one or two chapters of it after the whole year. Because there are so many hadith mubarakah, so many seerah books which you can quote at this point and go through all the hadith mubarakah that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned regarding his birth, that it will take us a whole year just to go through them all. Okay? So the more we open it, the longer it will take us. But inshallah, we're going to keep it concise and try to stick to the text itself. So Imam Barzanji rahimahullah ta'ala states here that when the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was apparent to the dunya, meaning when he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born, what happened? Wadi an yadayhi ala al-ardi rafi'an ra'sahu ila as-sama'i al-'aliyya. That he sallallahu alaihi wasallam had his hands raised on the ground, or rather he sallallahu alaihi wasallam placed his hands on the ground and he had his head raised towards the sky. Now this, we did this in Shifa, that this indicated the high intellect of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam even at birth. Even at birth, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood that the only one to be worshipped is none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he sallallahu alaihi wasallam placed his hands towards the ground and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam prostrated towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we have another sign here. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so intellectual at his own birth that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood that what is the greatest way and the most perfected way of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is that we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed. But then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also showed us that the best way and the most honored way and the most fullest way and the perfected way to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by prostrating towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For us, it takes us when we are adults to realize that we need to prostrate towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam prostrated towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as soon as he came into this dunya. That's the first thing he sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. Mumiyan bidhalika rafi ila su'dadihi wa ula. And this just was an indication of the great rank of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That our birth is prostrating towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa mushiran ila rif'ati qadrihi ala sa'il al-bariya. And this was a clear sign that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam holds a distinguished maqam and a distinguished rank above the rest of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will be upon the day of judgment when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be maqam mahmood. By himself on maqam mahmood and the rest of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praising him sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. وَأَنَّهُ الْحَبِيبُ الَّذِي حَسُنَ اتِّبَاهُ وَسَجَايَا. And he is the Habib of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the rank. The Habib holds every other rank that every other messenger has. It holds the rank of Khalil also. It holds the rank of Kalimullah, of Ruhullah, and the rest of the sifat of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. The rank of Habib holds all of them inside. So he was the Habib of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what happened? That ummuhu Abdul Muttalib. Then the mother of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was doing tawaf of the Kaaba. And what happened at the Kaaba, we've mentioned many times before in many of the mawlids of how he was doing tawaf of the Kaaba, and he realized before the call came to him, before the news came to him that Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been born, he knew that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being born, he knew that somebody or a child is being born in his house. Why? Because the Kaaba was prostrating towards the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And narrated by many of the muhaddithin, the Kaaba was prostrating towards the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, towards the house in which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was being born in. فَأَقْبَلَ مُصْرِئًا وَنَذْرَ إِلَيْهِ وَبَالَغَ مِنَ السُّرُورِ وَمُنَى. When he saw the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was no limit to the happiness that he had. He was overjoyed. He had such an extent of happiness that words cannot even explain. And he realized, وَأَدْخَلَهُ الْكَعْبَةَ الْغَرَّاءَ. And he took the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the Kaaba. وَقَامَ يَدْعُوا بِخُلُوصِ النِّيَّةِ. And he did dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the ihsan, the favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done upon him and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted him. وَوُلِدَ صَلَى اللَّهُ تَعَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ نَزِيفًا. And there were clear signs also that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was born, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born in a clean state. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had no need to be washed. After Sayyidina Amna radiallahu ta'ala anha had given birth to him sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam. Maqtu' as-surri. And the umbilical cord of the Messenger sallallahu ta'ala was naturally not there. It was simply not there. He sallallahu ta'ala was not attached to his mother. Rather, he was only dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he sallallahu ta'ala sallam, tayyiban, was pure, dahinan, and he sallallahu ta'ala naturally oiled, makhulatan tam bi kuhlil inaya aina, and he sallallahu ta'ala sallam had a natural kuhl in his eyes. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decorated him sallallahu ta'ala sallam and sent him to the dunya, and gifted him to the dunya. As you buy a gift, and you wrap it up in a nice wrap and gift it to the person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decorated the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then sent him towards the dunya, sent him towards his ummah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Then he said, wa awlama wa at'ama wa samma Muhammada, and then Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib gave food on the occasion of the birth of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he named Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and nobody else had been named Muhammad before this. This is a dhati name of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and a sifati name of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akrama maswa, and the maqam of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was honored, and the maqam of Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib was honored also by having the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.